Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing really well and hanging in there. Today I have what I've been buying during quarantine haul. I had no idea what to title or call today's video, but I'll be sharing with you some fashion and beauty. I've been shopping on Aritzia's website, over on Abercrombie, and then I've definitely been taking advantage of the spring savings event from Sephora. So I have my first order that I've placed to share with you today. I might do a follow-up video, what I've been buying during quarantine part two edition, because I have also pieces coming in from H&M, from Zara, some more from Abercrombie, and some more from Aritzia. So if you aren't already, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on any of my upcoming content. I have some really fun videos planned, especially for the month of May, that I'm really looking forward to. And if you want to come hang out with me over on Instagram stories, on TikTok, I'm really active over there, so I'd love to have you. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. So I think this is the first video I've ever filmed with a drink in hand. This is a Pink Whitney. My friend got me onto this. It's like pink lemonade vodka, and then I put some sparkling water in it, and then I'm drinking it out of like a champagne glass because we keep it classy over here. And yeah, it's pretty. If you add more pink lemonade vodka, it makes it really pink. Mine's quite diluted because that's how I like to drink it, but yeah. So we're going to kick things off, I think, with Aritzia, and then we'll move into Abercrombie, and then I think we'll finish off with Sephora. Yum. That is good. Alright, so from Aritzia, the first thing that I'm going to share with you is something that hasn't come in yet. I'm just going to insert a photo up on the screen. So this is a really cute tie front top from their Wilfred Free collection. Now, one thing I'm really enjoying about the Aritzia website, I'd never go in-store at Aritzia. I really don't love their in-store customer service experience. However, online, excellent. So they're actually letting you know what days that they're anticipating the items to ship to you. I think this is great because it helps you make a decision. You know how long it'll take for the item to arrive, so you can decide if you still really want it. For me, it's not an item I can really start wearing just yet because, you know, I have a sweater on. It's still a little bit chilly outside, so I was happy to wait until mid-May to get my hands on that top and still make the purchase, but they also have free returns right now. I've definitely been taking advantage of stocking up on basics. So I picked up this cute little white basic crop tank from Aritzia. I really like the strap detail on it. And this is just a really great versatile piece to have in your wardrobe that you can dress up or down. I could easily wear it underneath the sweater that I have on today. I'm just wearing a pair of high-waisted straight leg Levi wedgie fit jeans, and this would look really cute with it. Or I could wear it with a pair of denim shorts, a skirt, but I could easily style it with leggings or sweatpants. Next up, we have this cute little crop sweatshirt, and you may or may not realize this, but I've come to realize that I don't actually have a lot of loungewear or athleisure wear in my wardrobe. My style's just, it's not very casual, but it's not super dressy either. I'd say it's somewhere in between, but now being stuck at home, I've realized, okay, Lauren, you really don't have a lot of loungewear, so you need to get it together. So I was on Aritzia's website. I have ordered another sweatshirt and a pair of sweatpants, finally, since I only have one pair of sweatpants. Isn't that crazy? But I came across this cute little crop sweatshirt, and I love the color of it. This is the shade Matte Pearl, but they do come in a ton of different colors. And I like the style of it, and I also really like the length of it. It's cropped, but it's not too cropped. You could pair it with a pair of high-waisted jeans. That's how I've styled it. But it would still look really cute with sweatpants or a pair of leggings or a pair of denim shorts, for example. I love that it doesn't have a hood. I'm not really into hoodies. And then I really like the zip detail at the front, and it's super soft and cozy inside. So I recently did a massive wardrobe clear out. Like, I want to say I gave away at least probably 70 to 75% of my wardrobe. And it's allowed me to take a really good look at what I'm missing. And so I decided to pick up this really gorgeous satin skirt in this beautiful champagne color. It's a little bit dressy, and I appreciate that we can't really go out right now, but I still found that when I did want to go out, I was kind of lacking pieces that could be dressed up or dress down. Now, I do plan on shortening this skirt because I'm only 5'3" and it is just a little bit long on me, but it has an elasticated waist, so it's really easy to slip on and off. It is the most gorgeous color, and kind of how I envision styling it is one way is just even wearing like a top like I have on underneath my sweater today, and then just throwing a denim jacket over top of it and popping on a pair of heels, or you could go for a pair of sneakers, and that would be one way that you could dress down the skirt. But you could also really elevate it with a really pretty lace camisole, for example, and a cute cute pair of strappy heels and maybe like a little suede moto jacket or something like that. I forget how thirsty I get when I film videos. I mean, this probably isn't going to quite quench my thirst, but it's definitely helping. All right, so moving into Abercrombie, I picked up this really pretty lace bralette. Now, I ordered the majority of the items in a size small, and I definitely should have picked up everything in a size extra small. However, if you live on the west coast of Canada, so I live in Vancouver, Canada, oh my goodness, it took about 3 weeks for the items to arrive, and I'm happy I got them larger than too small because a lot of the pieces are selling out so quickly, so I can at least make some minor adjustments if they're a little bit too big, whereas if they were too small, there wouldn't be much I could do. But I don't really like wearing bras very much during the spring and summer months, so I'm definitely stocking up on cute little bralettes. This one is so beautiful. I just think it looks so expensive and high-end, but definitely did not have that price tag, and I also picked it up on sale. It has a bra-style clip at the back, and then it does have adjustable straps, so super cute. You could wear this underneath a camisole. You could wear it underneath like a sweater like I have on today. I think there's a lot of different ways you can style it, and it's just so much more comfortable than wearing a bra. Now, similar in style is this bodysuit. I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to hang on to it because it is a little bit too big on me, so I'm going to see if my mom can maybe help me take it in. Is it a little bit too sexy? Mom, my mom's watching my YouTube videos, by the way. Mom, do you think you can help me take this bodysuit in? It's a little bit big kind of through the sides, but I thought it was absolutely gorgeous. Now, I was hoping to kind of style it with jeans, but I'm a little bit concerned it might be a bit too sexy for that. So I spotted a different style bodysuit over on H&M's website. So I'm not sure if I'm going to hang on to both of them, but I do believe that this is sold out on the Abercrombie website, at least in my size. So I'm not sure if I'm going to hang on to it, but it's absolutely stunning. It has this open back detail. It has the clasp closure, adjustable straps. It's a thong style, which is amazing because you can easily wear it with jeans or with a skirt. And then it also has snaps at the bottom. And this was originally $79 Canadian. So I did get this on sale, I think 50% off. It was an absolute steal. So I'm hoping I can make it work. But I was actually really impressed just to find pieces like this on Abercrombie's website. Now, if you're looking at the rail behind me, you know I have a thing for light neutrals. So I picked up this really pretty tie front top, and I also grabbed it in this kind of light brown camel shade. Now, I picked up both these in a size small. I definitely could have done with an extra small just because I'm quite petite through the bust, but these are so gorgeous. They are incredibly soft, and I think they have such a beautiful, flattering neckline. With a pair of high-waisted jeans or high-waisted shorts, you don't actually have a lot of tummy on display. And again, I feel like these are pieces that you can wear quite casually. You could wear them with leggings or sweatpants if you so choose, but you could easily dress them up as well. So I just thought these were great basics, but still a little bit on the dressy side, and I just cannot get over how soft they are. So I'm definitely not going to do this bodysuit justice showing it to you on a hanger, so just wait for the try-on clip. But this is a bodysuit, and I just thought the color was so gorgeous, and the material is incredibly soft. It has a really kind of pretty drapey cowl neck. I do believe it comes in a few different colors. The back is like a cross detail, which I thought was really pretty. It also has a thong style, yes. And then it has snaps even better. One thing I noticed actually at Aritzia when I was browsing online is a lot of their bodysuits don't have snaps. Like, what's with that? I heard that people were complaining that the snaps are uncomfortable, but like, I just need that functionality in my life. So I was really happy that this piece came with snaps, but oh my goodness, how gorgeous. Again, another really great versatile piece that I feel like you can dress up or down. Now, I absolutely cannot resist a good little white dress, particularly during the spring and summer months, and you know, of course, on holiday as well. So I took advantage and grabbed a couple while they're on sale on Abercrombie's website. This one is in a linen fabric. It is completely lined. The straps are adjustable at the top, so they have that tie-off detail, which I thought was really pretty. It has a zip closure on the side, so really easy to step in and out of. And then it has a really pretty slit detail at the front. This is also another piece that I do need to get taken in because it's quite a bit bigger on me than I was anticipating. But you just can never go wrong with a cute little white dress because there's so many different ways that you can style it up. You can easily inject color with it. You can dress it up. You can dress it down, and there's no design details about this piece that scream, I'm going to go out of style after 2020, which is exactly what we're looking for. Now, this little white linen dress, I did manage to grab in an extra small, and it fits like a glove, and I'm absolutely in love with it. It has this really gorgeous wrap tie detail across the front here. It has smocking at the back, so it's super stretchy and comfortable on the body, and then it does have adjustable straps. Now, one thing I did want you to note with this piece is there is no zip closure, so you do need to pull it over your head, whereas with the other dress, you can actually step into it because it does have a zipper, which is, you gotta be a little bit careful with white. So make sure you're putting on like an old t-shirt or even a pajama top or something over top of your head once you've done your makeup, and then pull the dress on over top so that you don't get any transfer of makeup or any like dry shampoo or residue or even your self-tan on your gorgeous white dress. Let's get into what I picked up during the Sephora VIB sale. I'll put all the information in the description box about the sale down below in case you're wanting to check out or pick up any of the items that I share with you in today's video. So first up is the Translucent Setting Powder by Hourglass. This is, oh my goodness, the, I want to say maybe fourth or fifth time that I've picked up this setting powder. I absolutely love it. It just makes your makeup look so incredibly flawless and gorgeous. It retails for $60 Canadian, so it is not cheap by any means, and I always try and grab it whenever it's on sale, but I absolutely love it and I highly recommend it. Next up is the Clinique Take the Day Off Cleansing Balm. Again, this is about the fifth or sixth time that I've purchased this product. I have one in the master bath and I have another full size of these in my work suitcase. How you use this product, if you haven't tried it out before, it's absolutely amazing. You just rub it on top of your face while your makeup is on and it is completely dry, and it literally melts the makeup off your face. So I rub it all over my face and I just literally stick my head underwater. I rinse it off and then I go in with a cleanser. Next up is the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask, and this was sent to me accidentally. I didn't actually order this in my order. I double checked, but I did order it in my second order that has yet to arrive. Now, this is the original scent, which I already have, but since then they've come out with a few different other scents. I believe there's a grapefruit, a vanilla, there's a lime, melon? I can't remember, a lime something, and I went for the vanilla. So that should be coming in my next order. So I do need to figure out how to send this back to Sephora, since honestly, this will last you at least a year and a half. A little bit goes a long way. So next up is the Isle of Paradise self-tanning drops. I picked this up in the shade medium. I've never tried out this product before, but I do not like to go in the sun at all. I wear SPF 60 on my face and on my body. If I do need to go into the sun, I am very vain that way. So I've tried this out once. I just put a couple of drops into my moisturizer and then I went to bed. Be mindful about the fact if your moisturizer has not kind of sunk into your skin yet, if it's still wet, because it could kind of rub off on your pillow, and obviously you want to have a really even tan. But what I do love about this product is there's no color to it, so there's no transfer on to your pillowcase. You don't need to worry about your pillowcase looking dirty or going a funny color. So I love this, and it comes in three different shades, and I think the medium is absolutely perfect, especially if you're kind of more on the fair side like I am. So I've been wanting to get into fragrance a little bit more lately. I was in Sephora before, you know, quarantine happened, and one of the Sephora employees made me a sample of this perfume, and it's called Juliet Has a Gun, and it is not a perfume, and oh my goodness, I am absolutely in love with it, and it smells amazing. It's in a really, really pretty glass bottle, and then it just has like a little pump on the end, and you don't need much. It smells so good. A little bit honestly goes a long way. And I feel like this is just like the right size to try out a new perfume, because perfume can be so incredibly expensive. So this is around just under $40, it might be around $32, and then you can get between 10 to 20% off. So I think this is a really nice one to try from Sephora if you're not into overpowering kind of like florally feminine scents. I think you might really enjoy this one. So I also picked up a couple of lip glosses. I've been getting really into wearing different lip products lately, and I thought these were an absolute bargain. So I love the Fenty Beauty Gloss Bombs. I have the shade Diamond Milk, and then I also have the shade Glass Slipper. And then I spotted this duo on the Sephora website, and I just thought it was an absolute steal, and I don't have either of these shades. So this one right here, this is the shade Fenty Glow, and I am honestly obsessed with it. It looks a little bit intimidating in the bottle, but it goes on a lot more sheer. It's not quite as dark as that. And then this one is the shade, I think, Sweet Mouth. It is a really light pink color, also great little topper or just to wear it on its own if you want to add a little bit of color to your lips. The next thing I picked up is the Overlast Cheek Palette from NARS. It's absolutely stunning and I love the packaging. So on the interior, you get three highlighters at the top here and then you get three blush shades on the bottom. I have actually never really worn blush before and I'm trying to get a little bit more into it. I was just feeling so incredibly bored with my makeup over the past month. So I'm taking advantage of the sale and trying out some new products, and all of these shades are just absolutely stunning and I find that you can wear them a lot of different ways. So for example, the blushes, you don't only need to wear as a blush, you could easily wear them as an eyeshadow. The highlighters, you can wear as an eyeshadow as well, but you can also put it on your cheeks, down the bridge of your nose, on your Cupid's bow. That's exactly what I've done with this top middle shade right here, and it just gives you a nice kind of subtle glow from within. Now when I think about makeup, eyeshadow and lip products definitely excite me the most. This is the Afterglow eyeshadow palette from NARS. Now this retails, I think, for $78 Canadian, so I definitely wanted to take advantage getting it on sale. But how stunning is this palette? I think it is incredibly beautiful for spring and summer, and then even to transition into fall or to take with you on holiday. It's a little bit smaller than I was anticipating, but personally, I don't like really large palettes. But I also like palettes that I find you can create a lot of different looks from. Something that's appropriate for work, for daytime, but you can transition into evening or really glam up as well. And I feel like with this palette, you can do just that. I created today's look from this palette and I absolutely love the way that it turned out. Now there are so many products from Charlotte Tilbury that I absolutely love, especially her lipsticks, Pillow Talk and Very Victoria. I'm absolutely obsessed with them, but I spotted this really gorgeous eyeshadow palette from her. Now it is a mini size and it's steep in price. It's $75 Canadian, but of course you can get a discount during the sale. But when I saw the shades, I just thought, oh my goodness, like, are those not perfect for an everyday look or for an evening look? This is gonna be amazing to wear all year round, spring, summer, fall, winter, and then to travel with. The size is perfect and they've included a couple of matte shades and then some shimmer shades, which I love, and I just think you can create so many different gorgeous eyeshadow looks out of, and I cannot wait to start using it. I really hope that you found today's video entertaining and just a really good distraction. Make sure you subscribe for part two of what I've been buying during quarantine and of course the other content that I have coming up over the next couple of weeks. Take care of yourself and I can't wait to see you back here in my next one. Bye!